Life is so hectic and we have so much that we're trying to balance. Most people tend to make it look effortless, and in reality, it's not so glamorous. We sort of all figure out how to make it work for ourselves and for our families, and those sort of tricks and nuances, life hacks, that to me is how she does it. I'm Rachel Blumenthal, the founder of Cricut Circle, and this is How She Does It. I'm here with Daphne Oz, natural food chef, New York Times bestselling author, and co-host of ABC's The Chew. You had Philo 6 months ago.
I did, yeah.
And so I imagine that the mornings also changed. They were already hard enough as they were. And
now it's like 6 a.m. is a late morning. 6 a.m. is like, woo, I slept in.
You know? Yeah.
But she's made me a morning person now because she's in her best mood, her happiest, most alert, like, woo, exciting day, yeah. New day. And you want to be there for all of that.
You're getting to a phase now where she'll start eating.
Yes.
And we've sort of noticed that there is this big trend of this baby-led weaning and allowing the baby to sort of eat whatever they want.
Yeah.
I very much went the traditional method of listening to my friends and spreading out every 3 to 4 days each food. How are you sort of approaching all this?
Imagine you were a caveman and your baby started, you know, reaching for the first time for the water you were drinking. You'd probably let them have a sip of that water because for the first time ever they were expressing interest in it. And that's kind of how I started introducing water to her and letting her sort of drink from my cup. That's sort of how I've done food too. I think we worry a lot as moms about everything. I think we worry about, are they eating enough? Are they eating too much? Are they, you know, are they talking at the right space? Are they crawling properly? All this stuff. And I kind of feel like as long as, you know, they seem happy with the food, and my pediatrician said this, you know, they can kind of eat what you're eating.
Mom fail. She's only 6 months, so probably you haven't as many as I've had.
Without fail, every time that I let her be without a diaper, which is, if it were up to her, it would be all the time. But when I do, even if she's just peed, she will pee on whatever it is, the bed, the carpet, the whatever I'm changing her on, it's toast.
You've built this incredible career and you're so inspiring and you're gonna be such an incredible role model for Philo. What do you sort of hope that she takes away or learns from you or sees in you?
My parents, whenever they took us all on trips, were really big about instilling this fear in us that if we didn't go on every bike ride, on every, you know, walk around town, on every exploration, we would miss the best, most important experience of our lives. Although not every time was mind-blowing, earth-shattering revelations, the times that were, I'm so grateful I, you know, got up and said yes. I really want her to have that same sense of adventure, and I want her to have that ability to be a real kid. She's gonna grow up really fast, as much as I don't want her to, and in as many ways as I can, I really want her to have the richest childhood possible.